Hey guys, happy Sunday.
What's our happening? Fun days because
one, we're in sweats. Chef gets hot in the kitchen. Beans don't burn on the grill. What is happening? So today we are making shrimp. I even actually know how you say this. Shrimp.
Shrimp etouffee.
Etouffee. Is that what it's called?
Shrimp etouffee.
Okay, we are not from Louisiana, but I did grow up in Texarkana, which is three parts Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana. Okay, so Sundays usually are a day where we cook something new that we've never done because you got time.
And you just feel like you want a good meal on Sunday because I'm from the islands, and if you from the islands or went to the islands or know someone from the islands, you know that there's one day every one day of the week that everybody is guaranteed to have food in their house.
Oh yeah,
and that's
actually very
every
true.
Sunday
every
you go
Sunday.
To anybody's house on the islands and they'll have food, and you can walk in and they'll give you a plate of food.
We've been married 3 years.
Three and a half.
Yeah,
oh
man. And we love cooking
Fresh
for
prints.
People, and I love being in the kitchen. Surprisingly, as I get older, the more and more I like it. It's very therapeutic. So, and I love trying new recipes.
Did y'all grow up? Did your household grow up making meals on Sundays or like during the week?
How'd you get to love cooking? My dad loved to put a good half sandwich with some chips and a pickle together.
That's a good base.
But actually in LA, where my grandma and all the extended family is, every Sunday they did do a big meal. My grandma cooked. So it was kind of open house, open door.
And anybody could come over?
Anybody could come over.
Just like the islands.
So just like the
you
islands.
You see strangers walking in your house saying, can I get some food? And then you just say, oh yeah, go grab your plate.
You come in, you know who's cooking, you know who has the meal. So.
And secretly I was so mad because that meant all the food was not people's gonna eat up all the food and there won't be none left for me when I want it later on. I was just selfish.
I feel like
still selfish.
No, I wasn't gonna say that you're still selfish, but there is something about your food. Up in the veggies over here, we've got celery. I forgot to say it. This dish is from a Dallas blogger. Her name is Alex from the Defined Dish. She's one of my favorites, and I like it because she cooks pretty simple meals there for the weeknights. Hers is a Whole30 version, but there are a couple of items that we're not doing Whole30. So that she has ghee and arrowroot flour, which I did not have. So butter and flour it is.
You gotta add tweaks to things to make it your own, you know? I actually haven't looked at the recipe more than twice, so unsure of what I should be doing right now.
We actually don't know what we're doing, but we just thought it would be fun.
How should we chop?
Just a fine.
Because you've seen the recipe.
Oh, just like a fine chop.
You just chopped my neck. If you watch the Food Network, they always say you must chop like this and watch your hands at the same time. You know?
Okay. While he's doing that, I've got the shrimp. And so while he's chopping, I'm gonna actually saute this in some butter. I'll be back. Chopper.
A little fun fact about me, I do not like celery. I've recently been drinking celery juice, which I do kind of enjoy. So I guess I don't hate celery, but it's good for your health though. Celery is a good thing. So if you're out there celery juicing it or you haven't done it, you should probably start.
Oh yeah.
Remember we started recently doing it? Celery?
I started it and then I stopped.
I know, so recently.
My gut was never the same, it feels like. Okay, I think we're gonna continue chopping and then we'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Just like how all the Rachel Ray and them be doing it on and Bobby Flay do it on the show.
Okay, I'm over here cooking the shrimp. So our son has been napping for 2.5 hours. The Cowboys are about to start.
Boo.
Yeah, okay, we are a house divided. I am a Cowboys fan.
First of all, if you've ever heard the term fair weather fan, my Steelers have a rocky start. But I'm always,
they've lost all
always been a Steelers fan. I always will be a Steelers fan. And I don't deal with the fair weathers.
You know,
I
just
let them, let the fair weathers just talk.
Okay, but we don't actually know why you're a fan of the Steelers. Like, it makes no sense. You've been to no games.
Well, does that so? I don't see the air. I don't see the air I breathe. I still breathe it. They're not flashy or flamboyant with what they do. They're just a hard-nosed team that tackle, they hit hard, and they get the job done.
Oh.
And I want people, black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow. You can't be dancing there tonight.
Okay, the shrimp is cooking, so he's gonna finish dicing, and then we're gonna get it all mixed up.
So I just discovered that I forgot how to peel an onion, because it's been so long, so I was like, Jacqueline, how do you peel an onion again?
What does that actually tell you? Who's in the kitchen?
Me. My preference is to use this type of onion over this type of onion. Why? Because I have the most sensitive eyes known to man. And I'm about to start crying in 2 seconds just because of this onion.
While he's crying over there, I've got the shrimp all ready to go. That was super, super simple.
Baba Gump shrimp, Baba Gump shrimp.
Man, I want to eat these shrimp now. Y'all, I'm kind of sweating. Like, why I chose to wear a sweater? Because I'm out of office. And Zane woke up, for sure woke up, because I'm so loud. Somebody woke up. He's ready for a snack. I'm ready for a snack.
In case you're wondering, I'm still chopping. Much to chop up in here. Like, I've been chopping this whole video, but I must keep chopping. Why? Because teamwork makes the dream work. You know what I just realized? We actually have a bigger chopper than this little thing that could do all this at once, and I'm using this tiny little one.
I told you that.
No, I don't remember you telling me that. But it's too late
now. Actually, I handed him the wrong chopper.
Okay.
We want to see your muscles. Yeah.
I'm in it.
Praise the Lord for these measuring things on butter.
You know, a true chef like me knew that they always had those things, those measurements on the butter.
What does that even mean? Butter makes the world go round.
Well,
wait,
chopped.
What am I doing? Oh my gosh, I forgot what I was doing. Oh wow. And some flour, that's not Whole 30 approved. Okay, so we're making a little bit of a paste over here. I'm telling you, I'm sweating, but it's okay. Whew. Chef gets hot in the kitchen. Beans don't burn on the grill. Wait, is that the lyrics?
No. No.
Say it,
not
lunatic.
Even close. Not even close.
Nelly.
Not
beans
close.
Don't burn in the kitchen. Chefs don't burn in the grill.
That's even further away from the actual lyrics.
Ooh.
I got the skills that kills. Don't you love the sound of a good sizzle in the afternoon? A sizzle in the afternoon. That means, growing up, that means food's almost ready. That's what that sizzle means. You about to eat.
Yes.
About to eat.
But real, do you guys also cook on Sundays? Or what do you think about meals? I don't know. We are huge advocates of people around a table. That's where you have the good chats, the face-to-face chats. So while we're, you know, into all this Instagramming and YouTubing and all that, nothing will replace being face to face with people, having those heart to heart. So just a reminder, invite people into the home.
You know, you invite people in your home and feel like they're more likely to open up and feel that they can share with you and grow through life with you. And I mean, but here's the deal. Are you really friends if you haven't been invited to their homes? Are you though? Ask yourself.
We were talking about this with another group of friends the other day where it was like, I personally feel if someone has never invited me into their home, you're like on a certain level of friendship.
I'm just like, what you hiding?
What you
got something to hide? Let people in your space if you don't got nothing to hide. Now, if you don't want them in their space, that's something different.
That's totally fine.
And y'all ain't friends and it's clear. But if you're friends,
clear. Like, I literally know people that I've never been invited to their home in 4 years.
They ain't your friends.
But they've been over to my home. I don't know. People are really private. That's totally fine. And some people feel like they don't have the space to But let me tell you, we one live in an 800 square foot apartment, or 900, I don't know anymore. And you can sit on the floor and have a conversation. You could cook a grilled cheese sandwich with some tomato soup and call it a day. You can put a frozen pizza in and invite someone over and have a really awesome time. So it doesn't have to be fancy. Did I forget about the meal?
You did. But I think people get more fixated in the actual space and get wrapped up in the space must be perfect to entertain all that stuff. But really, people care more about the interactions you're having with each other. You know, the interactions together outweigh the space. So you could be in a crappy space, but if you have good fellowship, good relationship, good conversation, that's where the memories happen. That's where the relationship builds, and that's how you grow in your relationship. So the space is just a small part of the whole equation.
It is. True chefs have all their, you know, those little bowls, and they're like.
So we're gonna take a little break so you guys can hear from some of our sponsors. That our roux going.
All right.
There's a roux. There's in all the different spices. It's just working right now. Yeah. It's just
the shrimp.
Shrimp.
And then this guy. I'm never scared of diced tomatoes. I do not have 2 cups of chicken broth, I'll tell you that.
Oh man.
So I have chicken stock, which I know is completely different, but. Yes.
Wow, we almost had too much of a reduction.
Okay, why is that on super low? You gotta turn that up. Turn the heat up. That was my bad. I'm the one giving him the direction. This is a dream come true. Cooking with my husband in the kitchen. A super simple Sunday meal. Oh, almost forgot the fish sauce.
But never fear. Super chef husband's here.
So that's
to save the day.
Yep, 1 teaspoon of fish sauce. We did 2 cups of chicken broth.
So we'll put the details for you guys to find the recipe.
We'll link it to Alex's site.
It's getting thicker.
So he has mentioned that the sauce is getting thicker. So we're gonna stir away for 5 to 7 minutes, let that get thick. Then we're gonna add our shrimp. Then we're gonna heat up some cauliflower rice because we're keeping it as whole 30 as we can. Keeping it clean because you know this week there was some Chick-fil-A that was had. Oh, we're done. Yeah. Hi y'all. This is smelling bomb. Now we're gonna take this, our plate of shrimp, but it's going in. Oops, one got away. Oh my gosh. Oh man, this camera. I'm not like good. For real though, I could have done the whole bag. I just want people to know they can cook. You can cook. You can try something new. What I like about trying something new is because you never know what you can add to your rotation of family meals. Also, why is my leg popped? Like, why am I standing like this?
We're not sure.
Okay, so we're just gonna let that simmer. Then that's it. We out here. Totally thought we had cauliflower rice. But this will do. These are from Trader Joe's. Don't tell the people from the islands that I heat up a bag of rice.
Yeah, see how quiet I am?
Okay,
I'll get kicked off the island.
But who's gonna eat this? Sometimes you just need to heat up a bag of rice. And if you're questioning if I know how to make rice, I do. So.
Yeah, island people, this is like the worst thing in the world to do, but it's actually really, it's actually tasty.
Cheers!
We did it. Take a look at that.
Look at this.
See what we think.
Little gold forks. Are we ready? Hold on, mine is so hot.
It's hot. We're gonna burn our throat, Jess.
Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna do it because you know why?
No!
I care about y'all so much. I'm gonna hurt myself, y'all.
Okay. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
It's good.
Mm-hmm.
It has a little kick to
that
it too.
I got some kick.
It got some kick to it, so this is good. I feel like our Louisiana friends would be proud of this.
I feel like they'd be really proud. We're done.
We're done, and thanks for hanging out with us today. We gotta go catch the rest of this game, the Cowboys game, because I gotta root for...
3-7. Do we have some leftovers?
No.
I'll have some leftovers. Okay. See you next time, guys. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining us. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, because we got more videos coming your way.
Okay, bye.
Good. Go team, go.
Go team, go.
It's good.
Husband happy.
Happy husband, happy wife.
Happy wife.